off, please, and hashtag the ACCDN for updates on live streaming coverage, including commissioners' forum and all players and coaches' interviews. Laken Tomlinson is with us now. Laken, our protocol is to make sure that people identify themselves who they're with. We'll ask a question. We'll turn around in about 7 minutes, and we'll tell them. Great. First question for Laken, right here. What shirt do you got?
Hi, Laken. Kenny Beck, WSIN 12, local NBC here in Greensboro. For all the success Duke has had the last few years, Duke football still hasn't won a bowl game in 54 years. You're a senior. What would it mean to you personally, and what would it mean to the program to finally break that drought this year?
It would mean a lot to me. I mean, since coming in the past 2 years from a bowl game to losing, you know, it's a bad feel on you as a person and as a program. And, you know, losing that last game means a lot, and it's a good motivator for us to work even harder in the offseason so we can hopefully the next season win, go to bowl game and win bowl game. So it means a lot to me coming in my last season. And, I mean, we're going to do whatever it takes to finally get that win.
To our left, Reacher.
Hey, Lincoln, Jeff from WRL TV in Raleigh. Two-part question. When the poll comes out tomorrow, do you expect Duke to be predicted to win the division? And second of all, there are more offensive linemen here this week than quarterbacks. If you look across the conference, talk about the depth of the offensive linemen, including yourself, as far as incredible talent across the league.
I mean, so you wanted me to talk about just
linemen across the ACC. Some pretty elite company.
Oh, I mean, yeah, we got some great offensive linemen in the ACC. I mean, just look at each school, you know, Florida State, Boston College. You know, these guys, they exemplify a great offense with great run game. So that's what we try to kind of do at Duke too. You know, we're usually the passing team, but in a couple of years we've made major growth in our run offense, and you know that's definitely shows in our winning record. So I mean, I think the offensive line in the ACC just phenomenal.
Like you right here. I'm sorry.
Paul, do you expect to be paid to win your division?
Oh, of course. I mean, that's the goal, and even the entire ACC. You know, that's what we want to do, and that's what we work hard every day for.
Right here, like the road.
Laken, Dan Stora Broadcast Media. What can you say about the progression of Duke football? I mean, across the country, a lot of people know the basketball side of it, but you've really fought to establish yourselves in the ACC and nationally. What can you say about that?
I mean, coming in as a freshman at Duke University, obviously, you know, Duke was in a strong program, but working under the leadership of Coach Cut and some fantastic staff members there we have at Duke University, it's just been an extraordinary experience to be a part of a team that's come from so little, like everyone expecting so little from us to be, you know, one of the top teams in the ACC. So that definitely means a lot to me, and you know, we're going to keep working hard every day and to be trying to be number one.
We go one question here, then we'll do two on this side of the room.
Logan, Jim Connors from Time Warner Cable News. Your offense got so much from Brandon Kinnett the last couple of years. What are you going to do to replace his playmaking and his effectiveness, especially in the red zone?
Brandon Kinnett obviously was a very talented quarterback for us. Made some really big plays, really key plays last season for us that, you know, won us some games. But, you know, honestly, I think our team will be just as fine without him because we have so much more talent coming up this year that can replace Brandon Kinnett. We have Boone, you know, he can also win the ball too. We have Thomas Sir, you know, our number two quarterback right now, who's he's been working with the Lions and, you know, trying to get acclimated to the system that we're running here at Duke University. So I don't have any doubts that we'll be just as effective offensive wise.
Third row of your last thing, Paul Schroeder.
I'm Holly from Raleigh Laken. You suffered major losses. Jim just talked about one. Brandon, there are others. I won't list them because you know who they are. Obviously, you feel that the Duke's football program has matured to the point where you can have losses and still thrive and get better. What about the change in Duke's program makes you feel that you can do that?
Honestly, I would say it starts with recruiting. Getting the great athletes that we have at Duke University into the program has been just a phenomenal thing for us.
think that's it for Laken. Thank you very much.